So today in this video we are going to take up male reproductive system. So I hope you have studied about male reproductive system in 10th. So here male reproductive system consists of testes which are present in scrotal sacs. Then this vas deferens, this one is vas deferens. Then here there is seminal vesicle. That is gland associated with male reproductive system. Here this one is urinary bladder. This is urinary bladder where urine is stored. So this one is ureter. Pair of ureters are there. One ureter, this one is another ureter. And here there is prostate gland. This one is prostate gland. Gland associated with male reproductive system. Prostate gland is there. Here these are bulbourethral gland or Cowper's gland. We can see Cowper's gland or bulbourethral gland. Here this is penis. Here tip of penis, sensitive tip of penis is called glans penis. This is external genitalia of male. And retractable skin fold which is present on penis, it is called as foreskin. So these are different parts of male reproductive system. So let us start with primary sex organ of male reproductive system, that is testes. So testes are primary sex organ of male. These are primary sex organ of male. Remaining all are known as secondary sex organs. Remaining are known as secondary sex organs. For example, here vas deferens or this seminal vesicle, prostate gland, penis. So remaining all parts are secondary sex organ. Only testes are secondary, primary sex organ. Okay, so testes are primary sex organ. These are paired, pinkish, oval bodies. These are paired, pinkish, oval bodies. So this testes are present extra abdominally in scrotal sacs. These are present in scrotal sacs. So what are these scrotal sacs? Scrotum, it is present in upper thigh region in between two legs. So these are skin pouches arising from lower abdominal wall, present in upper thigh region in between two legs, and these are highly pigmented dark in color. So scrotal sacs, it contains such a testes. So here you can see testes are held in position by this fibromuscular band called gubernaculum. So this is called as gubernaculum. That is fibromuscular band. So testes are held in position by this gubernaculum. So why such a testes are present in such a scrotal sacs? Because spermatogenesis cannot take place at normal body temperature, that means 37 degree centigrade. So here in scrotal sacs, 2 to 2.5 degree less temperature is there in scrotal sacs. So 2 to 2.5 degree less temperature is there, and this temperature is suitable for spermatogenesis. So that is why testes are present in such a scrotal sac, that means skin pouches. Actually, testes are mesodermal in origin. Mesodermal in origin, and these are formed in abdominal cavity below kidneys. Okay, when testes are developed in male fetus, when there is development of male fetus in mother's womb, at that time testes of such a male child, testes of such a male fetus are developed in abdominal cavity below kidneys. But during 7th month of pregnancy, that means when 7th month of pregnancy is going on and male fetus is still present in mother's womb and there is 7th month of pregnancy, at that time that testes are descended down in such a scrotal sacs from abdominal cavity. Okay, so in these two are ureters, here somewhere here there will be kidneys, isn't it? So below kidneys there are pair of testes, one on this side and one on this side. So such a testes are descended down in scrotal sacs through ingual canal. Okay, and what is ingual hernia? Ingual hernia means if any loop of intestine is stuck in that ingual canal, then it is called as ingual hernia. It causes swelling in that particular part as well as pain in abdominal region. So such an ingual hernia only occurs in male. So ingual canal means canal through which testes are descended down to this scrotal sacs. Okay, so such testes are descended down in 7th month of pregnancy and FSH hormone is required for this. Which hormone is required? FSH hormone is required for this. So in this way testes are descended down in 7th month of pregnancy and then testes will remain here only in scrotal sacs. Now next, testes are mesodermal in origin, means during embryonic development testes are formed from mesoderm. Okay, so ectoderm forms some organ of baby, mesoderm forms some organ of baby and endoderm forms some other organs of baby during embryonic development. Here testes are formed from mesoderm. So testes are mesodermal in origin. Then what about length of testes? 4 to 5 centimeter length. Then 2 to 3 centimeter width and 3 centimeter thickness. Okay, testes have 4 to 5 centimeter length, 2 to 3 centimeter width and 3 centimeter thickness. Okay, so thus testes are abdominal in origin. So how we can say that testes are abdominal origin? Is there any proof for that? Here testes, it is covered by peritoneal covering called tunica vaginalis, this outermost covering of this testes, it is called as tunica vaginalis. Okay, so tunica vaginalis is peritoneal covering. So thus tunica vaginalis, it proves that testes are abdominal in origin. So tunica vaginalis, inner to tunica vaginalis there is covering called tunica albuginea. Outermost is tunica vaginalis, inner to tunica vaginalis there is tunica albuginea. Internally each testes is divided into 200 to 300 compartments called lobules. Okay, how many compartments are there? 200 to 300 compartments are there. 200 to 300 lobules are there. So each lobule contain 1 to 4 seminiferous tibials. Each lobule contain 1 to 4 seminiferous tibials. So here each lobule contain 1 to 4 seminiferous tibials. So thus how many compartments, how many lobules are there? 200 to 300. Outermost covering is tunica vaginalis. It is nothing but peritoneal covering. As we know that organs which are present in phloemic cavity, that is visceral organs, these are covered by peritoneal covering. So as there is peritoneal covering tunica vaginalis, that means it is abdominal in origin. Okay, and here inner to tunica vaginalis there is tunica albuginea. Okay, internally each testis is divided into how many compartments? 200 to 300 compartments called lobules. In CBSE book, direct 250 lobule it is given. 250 compartments are given. It is given in CBSE book, but as per your state board book, 200 to 300 lobules and each lobule with 1 to 4 seminiferous tibials. Okay, seminiferous tibial means what? Tibial means tube of very small diameter, that is called as tibial. Okay, tube, tibial, ductule, then granule. So such 1 to 4 seminiferous tibials are there in each compartment and such a seminiferous tibial produce sperms by spermatogenesis. Okay, so such a how many lobules are there? 200 to 300, and each one with 1 to 4 seminiferous tubules. All these seminiferous tubules, they are joined together to form network like structure called Peretti testis. Here network like structure is called as Peretti testis. This network like structure is called Peretti testis. All from this Peretti testis arise near about 10 to 20 small ductules called vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia, and such a vasa efferentia opens a epididymis. Such a vasa efferentia opens a epididymis. Here you can see this one is epididymis. This one is epididymis. So this is epididymis where sperms are stored. Then what are parts of epididymis? Here capute, corpus and caudal. Capute, corpus and caudal. These are parts of this epididymis. Okay. So this epididymis in which sperms are stored. So here such are testes. These are present in scrotal sacs. These are held in position by this gubernaculum. Gubernaculum, that is fibromuscular band. If you take section of testes, if you take TS of testes, then it shows such a large number of seminiferous tubules. You can see here, and each seminiferous tubule is having such a tall cells called Sertoli cells. Here these tall cells are known as Sertoli cells. And this one is germinal epithelium. Germinal epithelium. Cells of germinal epithelium undergoes meiosis. Cells of germinal epithelium undergoes meiosis to produce such a sperms. To produce such sperms. So sperms which are produced by meiosis are initially known as spermatid. And conversion of that spermatid into sperm, it is called as spermiogenesis. An entire process of sperm formation is called spermatogenesis. We will study about it afterwards. So here you only remember that germinal epithelium undergoes meiosis, that is reductional division, to form such a sperms called spermatogenesis. And what is function of such a Sertoli cells? So that sperms get attached with Sertoli cells by their head for getting nourishment from them. You can see here. Sperms are attached with Sertoli cells by their head only for getting nourishment from such a Sertoli cells. And once sperms become mature, then these are released in lumen of such a seminiferous tubule. So such a large number of seminiferous tubule. I have drawn here only one. Here also there will be such a seminiferous tubule having Sertoli cells and germinal epithelium which undergo meiosis. And here in between such a seminiferous tubule, there are interstitial cells or Leydig cell. Leydig is name of scientist. Leydig cell or interstitial cell. Leydig cell or interstitial cell. So these are Leydig cells. So these Leydig cell undergoes meiosis. Leydig cells undergoes meiosis. Sorry, Leydig cell produce testosterone hormone. Leydig cell produce testosterone hormone, which is responsible for development of secondary sexual characters in male. So such Leydig cell or interstitial cells secrete testosterone hormone. Okay, and this testosterone hormone is responsible for the development of secondary sexual characters in male. So this is TS of testes having such a seminiferous tubules and Leydig cells or interstitial cell, and such a Leydig cell secrete testosterone hormone. So this is about testes, TS of testes, okay, which produce sperms and testosterone hormone.